Voice of Freedom, the free world's first Earth satellite, is being heard around the world. Scientific pickups by the Minitrack Radio Network and by other radio facilities of the steady tone on the approved frequency of the Committee for the International Geophysical Year. The U.S. Explorer satellite is making itself heard while in orbit at altitudes from 230 to 1,600 miles at 18,000 miles per hour. And here, Pickering, Van Allen, von Braun, top spaceman scientists who sweated out the hours, days, and years until the Army's Jupiter C missile launched its artificial baby moon and with it hurtled democracy into the space age. Coordinated teamwork did it, from Huntsville, Alabama to Pasadena, California, from the pioneering Redstone rocket modified for the satellite mission to the four-stage Jupiter C. Development of the bullet-shaped satellite itself, combining the full capabilities of the Army Science Industry team. And now, while the Explorer completes one full orbit every 118 minutes, let us recount for history that dramatic hour of takeoff at Cape Canaveral. News of the day has shown you missile launchings in many recent issues, but here you are witness to an event which will be talked about with awesome reflection by your grandchildren. In 1958, free men everywhere lifted their gaze to Freedom's satellite. Feet, 65,000 pounds, the four-stage Jupiter C in the 8 p.m. The last three stages are set spinning on takeoff for guidance purposes. A special fuel, Hydyne, is giving greater thrust. In 145 seconds, the 78,000 pounds of thrust of the first stage will have lifted the missile to an altitude of 53 miles. The whole job takes about 7 minutes. In that time, the final three stages will have been fired in rapid succession, and the satellite accelerated to maximum speed for orbit. Finally, the Explorer, a 30 8/10 pound scientific bullet crammed with instruments, will begin the globe-circling travels which astound the imagination.